What it is, what it do, what it is, lads and ladettes. I am the HNIC, the head nerd in charge, Dakota Griswold of Gamers, Nerds, and Geeks United. Welcome back to Yesterday Today. This, of course, is the show where I bring you some of the biggest gaming news you may have missed from yesterday, today, well, over the weekend. And well, today, I want to get into these appetizers because there is some interesting stuff to really cover here. And let's jump right into it. Apparently, it's not 2020. It is 1999 because Gateway PCs are now back on sale. Yes. Now, they are officially on sale at Walmart.com, and they range from about $200 to $1,200. Get this? They're coming bundled in with Game Pass. Xbox may have won the console war in a sense because Xbox is getting ready to be everywhere, okay? We almost heard about them trying to get onto the Nintendo Switch, and we know PlayStation ain't having it, but the fact that Xbox is on PC and now being bundled in with brand new PCs that you can go buy, well, that's quite interesting. So the Gateway PCs range from about $200 to $1,200, more expensive, and they have all of the more expensive parts and stuff like that in it. But this is very, very interesting because it was really, really random over the weekend. But honestly, if you're like me and you got a nostalgia factor, well, this is pretty interesting. Maybe I'll get one of these, something like that, and just... I don't know. That doesn't make sense for me to just have it. But this, they seem like a little bit of a collectible thing, because how long is this going to go on for? Are they back permanently or whatever? But Walmart is exclusively selling them. And once again, if they're powerful enough to run Xbox Game Pass, well, maybe do get one if you want to have a little entry fee into the Xbox with Game Pass on the PC. But wow, Gateway. You know, those cow-spotted boxes and PCs, That's really interesting to see it back. That's awesome. It's just, you know, some greatness from yesteryear. Now let's jump into the next one. And so, well, of course, at this point, maybe the most hyped game of the year still, Cyberpunk 2077. While it's coming out in November, well, on September 18th, we have another Night City Wire update, and that will be on September 16th. This week, and I'm letting you know right now, this is going to be a really, really great week for news, and they're going to highlight the gangs and stuff like this on this Night City Wire. I tend to watch all of these and then talk about them and then do some coverage because these are really, really awesome. I really don't want to see any more of the game because I've been sold on the game since even before we saw the fact that Johnny Silverhand, aka Keanu Reeves, was in the game. But I am really, really excited about this. I watch all of them because it's just like, how much more in depth could you do? And then we also heard about the multiplayer. Yeah, there's going to be microtransactions in the multiplayer, but I guess that's just all cosmetic. I'm really interested to see what they're going to do with this. Just a few more months. This comes out right alongside the launch of Next Gen, and maybe soon we'll know about when the PS5 is releasing. But honestly, I'm getting this day one on whichever Next Gen system it comes on. Moving on to the next one, and well, shout out to all my Borderlands fans. And well, if you like to play Borderlands a lot and you have three other buddies on the Next Gen, you can play split screen in 4K. Yeah. 4K split screen, four people, okay? And then if it's just two people, you can decide if you want to split this way or this way. You understand what I'm saying? Back in the day. So I think I do remember a Borderlands back in the day on maybe the 360 or the early Xbox One days where you really couldn't choose how you wanted to split it. And I was playing with my cousin and it was just really, really weird. But this actually excites me. This is very, very interesting because it's letting us know how powerful these new systems are. And if it can run a chaotic game like Borderlands, a looter shooter, where stuff is just always happening and how fast stuff is happening, and it can run it at 4K, yeah, I definitely think we should keep our eyes on all of the stuff that's getting ready to happen next gen as far as this type of technology. And well, so if you play Call of Duty like I do and you play it online and you're shooting, you hate the damage flinch. And what I mean by that is if you're aiming and you get and you're shooting and then you get shot, it takes you straight out of aiming mode. Well, the Tony Flame, the lead game designer over at Treyarch, he confirmed for us like, nah, that's not happening anymore. He released out on Twitter. He said, damage flinch has been redesigned in Black Ops Cold War. Flinch is now primarily a feedback mechanism to help you understand you're taking damage without affecting the aim position of your weapon. Your weapon will move with your screen to stay on target. No more flinch headshots. So basically, you would have a shot lined up and then you would get shot and then you, you know, and then basically you miss the shot. So a lot of kills that have been missed. This is why I like Call of Duty all over again. They have been fixing a lot of the issues that I had primarily like 10 years ago when I stopped playing them. So like the whole knife issue, the what was that perk called? I forgot what the perk was called, where basically you could just, you know, if you press the melee button, you could just do anything and win. I'm talking about slicing people on their ankle and they're dying, or somebody being 20 feet in front of you, put 20 rounds in your chest, but because it's commando, when you have commando, you can just slide across the floor through the bullets and still kill somebody. If you play Call of Duty and you're watching this, you know exactly what I'm talking about. And honestly, since I've been playing Modern Warfare, I haven't really been playing many other games right before it. That's not in Modern Warfare, and I'm pretty sure that's not going to continue to be in games to come. So I really, really, really can't stand it. And now damage flinch, whereas in Modern Warfare, I started to get really, really pretty good at Call of Duty, but a lot of my shots were missed because I had that damage flinch factor. So now with that happening, I want to see who's going to stop me. Y'all don't want this smoke. I ain't saying I'm going to the pros, but I'm all right. I'm going to say, like, yo, I love video games. I never said I'm good at them. I'm pretty decent at this one. If we're just keeping it real. So Jabari, Sean, squad up. Let's go on there when this game comes out, and we're going to show them how we get done. Now, moving on to the next piece of it. And I didn't really want to say anything about this because a friend of mine, he sent this to me last week. Shout out to my man, B, last week. And I didn't really want to believe it. And he didn't either. But GamesRadar put it out there, so there might be some type of weight to it. And I still say take this with a grain of salt. But there is going to be yet another Xbox introduced into the fray. The Xbox Series V. Yeah, doesn't really sound alike, but it looks like a bit of a slimmer Xbox Series X. But it also is all digital and is closer to the powers of the Series X, not the Series S. And honestly, I don't know. Do we really need this? Maybe something in the middle, fine, because the Xbox Series X is $500. Maybe the Series V would be $400, and they trying to cover $299, $399, and $499, whatever. Maybe this is real. But this is also said not to be completely as powerful as the Series X. Honestly, I actually appreciate this a little bit. It's simply because I'm old school. I like to go physical. So the Series X is the most powerful system, right? And it also has a disk drive. None of the other two, have disk drives. They're just all digital. If you want the best, you gotta go physical. Of course, the disk drives cost more or whatever, but $500, $400, and maybe $300. This is really, really interesting. I can't wait to hear more about this, but we haven't had anything confirmed about it. But Series V, it actually looks legit, like a good picture, but I'm really, really not sure. I really, really can't say. Not yet, but just wanted to put it out there just in case it comes out. I want to get right in front of this. I can't front. So lastly, for the appetizers, and well, the hard drives that you get to put into the new systems, the Xbox Series X, they're hot swappable, meaning even though the system's on, you don't have to completely put them down and reboot them or anything like that. You can pull them right out and put them into one of the other Xbox systems. The Seagate cards, you can basically put them into the Xbox systems and basically just take them wherever you want. Sounds like memory cards all over, but these things are probably going to be pretty big. But no pricing has yet been confirmed, but a lot of people think that these things are going to be about $200. And the one for the Xbox Series X is only going to be 1 terabyte. That sucks. The Series S is going to have 512 gigabytes. Given the fact that these games are so big, especially going into the next generation, right? I'm really concerned about this. Because early in the generation, I'm pretty sure games are going to be a lot bigger because people are still learning, developers are really still learning how to really deal with these files and how to compress the files. So a 60 gig patch down the road might only be 20 to 30 or maybe even less because they found a way to compress these files. But being able to move around these hard drives and these SSDs and stuff still being able to move fast, I'm really, really excited about this because it makes things a lot easier, because it's looking like that I might get a Series X and a Series S, because why not? One have one in one room and have another in the other room. And given the fact that you can just straight up move it over to another room, yeah, I'm all set for that. I'm definitely, definitely interested in that one. All right, lads and ladders, let's get into the real meat and potatoes. Some pretty big, but you know, not too crazy stories, but they're very interesting. So a lot of people might really be upset because if you hadn't pre-ordered the Mario 3D All-Stars at a certain time, well, you might have lucked out, because Base.com, that's based in the UK, knee slapper, basically they said that we have to cancel some of y'all pre-orders because we don't have as many as we thought we did. So they released an official statement that says, "We have just been notified of our allocation of Super Mario 3D All-Stars, and it is woefully short. This is very disappointing, and it is with great regret that we have to inform you that we will be unable to fill you, the fans, order to on the sixth day of release. Further, as Nintendo and their UK distributors are unable to give us any reassurance that more stock will become available after release, we have taken the regrettable decision to cancel all orders, all of them." That's crazy. Maybe just keep the people who got there first. Nah, they just said, let's cancel all of them. So we already knew that there was going to be an issue, trouble in paradise, shout out to Kofi Kingston, with this game, because Nintendo was only releasing it from this week of September 18th, and we can only get it until March. And then not even digitally, we can have the game anymore, which is really, really interesting. I have no idea why Nintendo is doing this, but now they're getting it canceled. And that really just concerns me over here in the US, because I definitely pre-ordered it maybe sometime in the middle of last week, and it still says it's shipping as of the recording of this video. It's still coming out for me this Friday, and I'm still very excited because I will probably be dedicating most of my time to these 3D All-Star games, probably, because these are three Mario games that I never finished. I actually own Mario Sunshine, but I was not a fan of the camera, never really got a chance to play Mario 64, and never played Galaxy. So I'm really, really interested, hoping that it doesn't get canceled, because if it does get canceled, I might be forced to buy it digitally. I don't like my hand being forced like that. COVID has definitely made me do that. I don't want to have to do that, because this means I can actually have that. And this is just a piece of a collector's, like, you can have it. Maybe you might even want to buy a second one just for collectors to have that red on the shelf and stuff like that. But this is a very sad case, and I'm really hoping that people can still find a way to get this game, because even maybe at your local mom and pop shops, it might be hard to have it because they're in such limited quantity. And yeah, I'm really, really concerned about that, man. It's just, I hope you weren't one of the ones who actually took the L. I really hope that, you know, everybody could come, this can all come around, and we can definitely start getting copies, and everybody is just happy about Mario 3D All-Stars. Now, moving on, this week, we get to hear a new PlayStation 5 event. Get to see a new PlayStation 5 event, and it happens September 18th, and it will be 4 p.m. Eastern time and 1 p.m. Pacific time. And well, it's exciting. It's very, very exciting. Excuse me, September 16th. It will be on September 16th, 2 days before the Night City Wire. And this is very interesting to me, right? Because they said you're going to get more PS5 news and more PS5 games about the launch titles and beyond. So probably in the launch window, maybe sometime in the next year. I really think we're going to get all of the games. Well, first of all, we're going to get the price, the release date and the pricing. And we're also going to find out about other games that's coming out as well. And of course, probably some more hardware stuff. And I'm really, really excited about this. But it's crazy to me because this is 2 days before the Night City Wire. Night City Wire is on the 18th. Are they going to move the date to go directly with the PS5? Because if they are, that's my launch title. PS5 drops, I'm walking away with probably Spider-Man, Miles Morales, and Cyberpunk 2077. Honestly, well, you can lock yourself in a cave for at least a month or two with that type of stuff right there. So I'm really, really excited that this is finally happening. And September 22nd, we can start pre-ordering. That's next week. We can start pre-ordering the Xbox. When are we going to start being able to pre-order our PS5? The PS5, that's probably going to be about $500 as well. And if we're going to be doing that, we're going to need a lot more time. Maybe they let us know we can start pre-ordering on the 22nd or the 23rd. Sometime close, and I really want to have that. And don't keep in mind, GameStop is giving you basically the lease where you can basically just, hey, look, let me give you $30 this month and $30 the next month, so $30 every month. So this way I can just pay off the system. They plan on doing that, even if PlayStation doesn't plan on doing it themselves. So this is really, really interesting. I can't wait to hear about it. And I hope that Cyberpunk 2077 on Friday, they decide, hey, listen, we're going to push the game up. Okay. It's coming out alongside the PS5 Series X. And yeah, Oh, also, I'm really hoping that we get to see a new God of War, because the last God of War came out in 2018. It's 2020. So let's just get a glimpse. 3 years later, let's just get a glimpse. They did say they was working on it. And it comes out maybe fall next year, maybe even mid of next year, okay? Sony, first party games, they're top level tier. Can't wait to hear about it. Can't wait to see it. I'm really, really excited. So I will be working this week, but I will be doing coverage inside yesterday, today for all of these events. So keep that in mind. I'm really, really excited to see all of this. I hope you are as well. But lads and laddies, thank you so much for watching. Go ahead and like this video if you haven't already. Go ahead and hit the dislike if you have a problem. It's all good. Go ahead and subscribe and scroll all the way up to all if you're new here. And please share this everywhere. And this video, lads and laddies, is finito.